Queensland's state budget is out today and the Premier is touting major cost of living relief for those doing it tough. Live to Jacqueline Robson in Brisbane. Jacqueline, good morning. What are the big ticket items this year?
Well, Anne, the centrepiece of this pre-election budget is $5 billion to help struggling Queensland families afford that rising cost of living. The government has been drip-feeding measures over the past few weeks, including 50-cent public transport fares, car rego slashed, and a $1,000 energy rebate to help with the power bills. But today, the latest measure was a freeze to fees and charges, like the cost of a driver's licence. And this is very much an attempt by the Labor government to claw back some of its leaking voter base with diabolical polls ahead of the October election. The Premier, Stephen Miles, hoping this budget, his first, isn't also his last. It's set to post a surplus of $500 million, but despite soaring revenue to $87 billion, thanks to the state's coal mining royalties, the state is spiralling into debt, the second highest it's ever seen, at $3 billion. The Treasurer, though, says this is a budget for a growing state. Take a listen.
Right at the heart of what we're doing in this budget has been the extraordinary impact of population growth. We've been going through and may still be going through the biggest influx of people that our state has ever seen. In the most recent 12 months of data that we've got, we've seen a population increase of 144,000 people.
Now, there's also money in health with a $1.7 billion package to try and lure aspiring GPs to the state. There's also stamp duty concessions for first home buyers to try and get young people into the property market. And there's also a $26 billion renewable energies push. And this is very much a race to the election in October.